Hi everyone! Welcome again to my channel, English Bites. Ngayon po ay tutuloy natin ang ating lesson. Dito na po tayo sa lesson 3 ng module 1. By the way, ang module po ng grade 10 o lahat po ng grade level ay binubuo ng from module 1 to module 7 or module 8. At bawat module ay binubuo ng halos 4 lessons sa bawat module. And now we have read it through with lesson 1 and lesson 2 for module 1. Narito na po tayo ngayon sa lesson 3 ng module 1, Constructing Personal Informative Speech. By the way, ito po ay sa quarter 1 lang ng English 10. And habang dinidiscuss po natin ito, dapat po ay hawak ninyo ang inyong mga module para masundan ninyo at maisurat na rin ninyo ang inyong mga answer. Okay. Lesson 3, Constructing Personal Informative Speech. At the end of this lesson, you are expected to do the following. Use information from informative talks that can be used in everyday life. And then promote the interest and sense of responsibility in validating the quality of information needed in academic and personal use by composing a descriptive speech, and last one, develop the abilities to organize information and construct it into a text. By the way, bago tayo magpatuloy, if you have not yet subscribed in this channel, please mag-subscribe po muna tayo, and then click na rin po ang notification bell para palagi tayong updated sa ating next video. Okay. What is new? Ito po ang unang bahagi ng ating module. In the previous lesson, you have learned the different types of speeches according to its purpose. You have learned also that speeches can inform, describe, entertain, and persuade. Now, these different types of speeches will help you recognize the information needed to be used in your everyday lives. It will be particularly helpful in recognizing the relevance of the data by arranging them in its proper sequence. Okay, dito na po tayo sa unang importanteng activity. What is new? Now, you are going to read the following speech below. Take down important notes as you go along and answer the questions that follow. Now, kayo na lang po ang magbasa nito para hindi tayo masyadong gumamit ng maraming oras. And then after reading this, you are going to answer the given questions. Okay, ito po ang karugtong. Ayan. Basahin ninyo ito. And then afterward, ay bibigay natin ang mga sagot sa mga questions na ito. Okay, here are the questions. What did Marie Curie discover? Okay, be ready with your ball pen and your answer sheet. For number one, what did Marie Curie discover? Marie Curie discovered radium. Okay, radium. Number two, what did she find out about uranium compound? Okay, she found out that uranium compound was active. Alright, she found out that uranium compound was active. Number three, how old was radium when she discovered it? All right, for number three, radium was more than 20 years old when it was discovered. And then number four, when did she engage herself in working on uranium rays? All right, if you are going to read the text, she was engaged in the year 1897. Okay, let us review. If that is correct, that is 1897. Okay. Now, number five, who discovered the uranium rays? Okay, the answer is Professor Becquerel discovered the uranium rays. Okay, this is Professor Becquerel. Okay, now, let us continue. Next part in your module, what is it? An informative speech is one that intends to educate the audience. Ano bang informative speech? Ito yung nagtuturo sa mga audience on a certain topic. This type of speech uses descriptions, demonstrations, vivid details, and definitions to explain a subject, person, or place the audience want or place that the audience want to understand. By the way, pag sinabi nating descriptions, ito yung naglalarawan. By the way, remember this is about informative speech. Pag sinabi natin informative speech, ito yung naglalarawan. Nagdi-demonstrate. Pag sinabi natin demonstration, nagpapakita kung paano ang paggawa ng isang bagay. And it gives vivid details. Pag sinabi natin vivid details, nagbibigay ito ng mga eksaktong detalye. And then it also defines and explains, nagpapaliwanag sa tamang pamamaraan tungkol sa isang subject, person, o mga lugar na gustong malaman ng mga audience. Okay. An informative speech makes a complex topic easy to understand. Yung mga complicated na topic, nagiging madali siyang maunawaan kapag ang ginagamit natin ay informative speech. It is easy to understand if you are going to use informative speech. And then it also offers different point of view. Nagbibigay ng iba't ibang uri ng pananaw. It should rely less on pathos. By the way, when we say pathos, it is about emotions. It deals about emotions. But in informative speech, it does not rely on pathos, but rather, it relies on vivid details. Pag sinabi natin vivid details, it is about visual aids. Ano-ano ba yung mga bagay na nakikita? Yan. But in pathos, ito lang yung sa mga emotions, yung mga nararamdaman. But when we say visual, vivid details, as I've said, it is about visual aids. Yung mga nakikita, nasasalat, at yung mga napapansin. Okay. Next. These are the types of informative speech. Number one, descriptive. Pag sinabi natin descriptive, it helps the speaker create an accurate mental picture in the mind. Nabubuo yung isang bagay sa kanyang kaisipan sa pamamagitan ng pagpapaliwanag, pagpapakita kung paano gawin ang isang bagay. About a specific person, place, or thing. Number two, demonstrative. When I say demonstrative, it describes how to perform an action. Naglalarawan kung paano gawin ang isang bagay. Explanatory, number three, it explains the state of a topic. It is very self-explanatory. Nagpapaliwanag tungkol sa isang topic. And then definition, it explains a concept or theory regarding a topic. Okay. Sa next part ng module nyo, what's more? Informative speech has different types depending on the speaker and what fits the audience. This time you will answer another activity that will enhance your knowledge on using the information on different types of informative talks. Now, sa activity 3.2, you are going to choose your best picture. Pipili kayo ng isang larawan. Come up with words or phrases that best describe your chosen picture. Make sure to be specific and detailed with your description. Write your answer on the worksheet provided. Now, for those who are having difficulty in doing this activity, I have prepared here a sample answer for activity 3.2. You may copy this down, but you may also you can try to add some more details about your school. Dito, ang napili ko ay about our school. Kung ano yung inyong school, anong itsura ng inyong school, ilarawan ninyo rito, i-describe ninyo. So for example, our school is one of the best landmarks in our community. Kung inyong community ay barangay, lagay niyo barangay o municipality. Okay. Or sitio dito. And then it is composed of ilang building ang inyong school. Ilagay niyo rito kung lima o pito, ilagay rito sa blank. And it has wide and trim school ground in front of the flagpole. Karamihan naman sa mga school ay ganito, may school ground sa harap ng flagpole. It has multi-purpose covered court. Kung meron kayong multi-purpose covered court, ilagay niyo rito. Ilagay niyo kung merong basketball court dyan, may volleyball court, ilagay ninyo. And then, kung ang school ninyo ay merong perimeter fence or perimeter wall, ilagay rin ninyo katulad nito. Our school is enclosed with painted perimeter wall. That is for activity 3.2. Now, dito naman tayo sa next part ng module, what I have learned. Sa activity 3.3, complete the paragraph below by giving appropriate answers to what you have learned from the lesson. Lalagyan niyo ng answer dito sa mga blanko. And then, para sa inyong answer, you should worksheet 3.3. Now, first answer, be ready with your ball pen and your paper. Okay, first answer is description. And then, explanation. And next is definition. And then, demonstrative. Now, for the next part, this will help me in understanding informative speech. Okay, next na tayo. What I can do? This time, I believe that you are ready to use data or information that can come up with an informative speech. You are going to use the information that you have cited in activity 3.1. And you are going to compose a 3-paragraph descriptive speech. Now, for this 3-paragraph descriptive speech, ito yung speech tukol kay Marie Curie and this discovery of uranium. Okay, this is the possible answer. Now, you should try to copy this example. Remember, this is only an example, but you can revise this as your own answer. By the way, pare-pareho naman ang topic ito is about the excerpt from Marie Curie's speech on the discovery of radium. By the way, as I've said, you can revise this, rephrase this, and as I have said, this is only an example of informative speeches. This is a possible answer for activity 3.4. Okay. Now, you should watch out for the continuation of this lesson on my next video about lesson 4, entitled Organizing Panel Discussion in Making Decisions. Dito kasama na rito yung pag-answer natin sa assessment. So this is very, very important. Now, if you have learned something from this video, again, please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the notification bell in order to be updated, and of course, please share also. Thank you very much for watching. See you again.